Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Today we have another Instagram versus reality where I merge my actual degree of photography, editorial and advertising photography with my new life as an influencer, and we take a look at brands, celebrities, influencers who use filters, etc. on video and photo to basically sell products with fake results, I guess. I always had to put a disclaimer, I don't mind filters, knock yourself out, have fun. Where I don't like them is when brands and adverts use them, again, to falsify, is falsify a real word? Yeah, falsify the results of a skincare product or the way an item of clothing is going to make you look, for example, things like that. First of all, though, we have an update. In my previous video, we talked about brands mainly who used filters and heavy photoshopping on their adverts to fake results of products. One of them being Foreo, who kind of photoshopped this bizarre before and after of what one of their eye massaging tools does. And whenever I call out brands, none of them really care or they don't even see my videos. Foreo, however, who honestly I have quite a good working relationship with, got in touch with me and said this. Hi, James, we're reaching out regarding the recent video on your YouTube channel, blah, 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 blah. Firstly, we'd like to thank you for raising this issue. The use of filters is a contentious issue, and as strong proponent of natural beauty and being happy in your own skin, we do not encourage the use of filters or manipulation on any photos that we post as a brand. Whilst we do vet all content to the best of our ability to ensure it is true to life and not distorted by filters or Photoshop effects, we can see that on this occasion this photo slipped through the net, for which we are sorry. We are constantly reviewing our internal moderation process across our many channels to ensure that we are only putting forward positive and truthful content. We really appreciate your feedback, and as you say yourself in your video, Foreo products do deliver on their claims, and the before and after results are impressive without the need for any filters or edits. We just want to reach out and thank you for the work you are doing. So yes, thank you for reaching out, Foreo, and thank you for explaining and all that kind of stuff. They actually reached out to me previously when an influencer was using a filter on one of their sponsorships, and from what I saw, they took it down. They have been the only brand, and bearing in mind, I do reach out to brands for comment before these videos, and not a single one has got back to me. Foreo have always been amazing at sorting their shit out, basically. So thank you, Foreo. So today I'm actually going to be doing my hair. I get a lot of hair questions, so I'm going to be doing it whilst we look at these Kardashian-Jenner specials. And I chose to do a Kardashian-Jenner special today, not because I don't like them in any way. The only thing I know about them is what I do for these videos and their beauty ranges. I know they're problematic, shall we say, but I also think they're a really good example of the types of editing, photo and video manipulation that goes on in today's beauty world. When it comes to both professional photography and videography and retouching to their own personal social media. So they're kind of like a case study in a way. In fact, I would say almost like 96% of the Kardashian-Jenner images and videos have been manipulated in some way, in any picture of them. And I emphasize that this isn't just what the Kardashians are doing. This is what everyone everywhere is doing. Brands, influencers, celebrities, they all do this. And this has been done way before the Kardashians. Some of them were even born. So as I said, they're just a very good example of what we see online today. So my iPad is here. I look at the pictures and videos here. So let's start off with one of Kim Kardashian's most recent campaigns. That's for Balenciaga. Here she is, just sitting on a sofa, looking in a mirror. This is like awkwardly casual. They're doing like this whole I'm not posing, I'm just doing things, modeling things at the moment. It may as well just be a still picture, to be honest with you. As super basic and plain as this video looks, there is some digital manipulation going on in the commonplace of the waist and the hips. If we look very closely to the left of the video on her left hip, when she puts the bag down and moves her elbow over her waist, the background glitches. You can see whatever mask is being used to reshape the body, it stops. It like just jumps and glitches out of place. Now, I'm not sure exactly what's being used here. I'm gonna call it a mask for now. But we see this line that almost looks like the edge of the mask appear as she goes to adjust the bag, and then we get the whole wobbly background appear and then snap back into place. Then another glitch here, the mask glitching through her body. So you can kind of see like this random white thing appear. This is where, if you look really closely, roughly where the original line of her waist would have been. So at first I was like, is this some kind of like old film effect, you know, like speckly dust effect? But when I looked throughout the campaign, that filter hasn't been used, first of all in this video, but any other video with any other models. And of course we have the usual color correction, filters, lighting effects that's been used to almost make this look like a printed magazine. I do quite like what they've done here. But yeah, there's definitely something going on with her hip here. But also, when we look at the image version of this, of course this is edited. For as long as there has been fashion and beauty in print, there has been some form of editing going on. Her waist has been slimmed and smoothed. So this looks like, this is the weirdest thing, because it looks like her leg kind of like carries on around her body, and it looks like a really dodgy editing mistake. But when we actually look at the video, all we see is it's just the way she's sitting that makes it look like she's got like a continuous leg, when actually that's the waistband. When you look at the items of clothing, that's just like a really tight waistband. So yeah, nothing surprising here. This isn't Kim doing it herself. This usually is always done when a celebrity features in a high-end fashion shoot, campaign, story, whatever you want to call it. I thought it would have been a little less obvious in such a bland kind of setting, but oh well. Let's move on to the whole family, the Kardashians with the Jenners and their Calvin Klein shoot. I don't know when this was. I don't really care. I don't like Calvin Klein for many reasons. Of course, it's retouched like a traditional fashion campaign. Always is. What I would say is, as a campaign, it's outdated in the sense that we are presented with a less diverse range of body types, colors, tones, people in general. But to be honest, whatever size the model is, they are going to be retouched, whether it's to make curves curvier, muscle musclier. There was actually like this whole scandal. Was it like, I feel like a brand like Boohoo, who were making models purposely bigger so they could be classed as plus size models when they weren't actually plus size. I'll have to look that up. I can't remember what that was about. But also, I would say this isn't a whole one shot. I think we all know that by now. What usually happens is they take the best of, like, when it comes to celebrities, models is kind of a different story, but they would take the best shot of each person and kind of composite that together, whether they've been shot separately or together or whatever. With professional high-end shoots like this, what we won't be looking for when it comes to editing is warping backgrounds, bendy walls, you know, nothing like that. What we will be looking for is odd editing choices. Too much skin work, you get that uncanny valley kind of look. Shadowless and textureless limbs, for example. In this case, it's oddly thin arms. Look at that one at the back. What's she called? Courtney? This is a weird time. Okay, so there's a few things this could be. Part of me doesn't think this is poorly photoshopped to be slimmer. My only guess, as someone who hasn't retouched for a long time, is that they've reshaped the body here, added back in the background to hide warping, and then forgot to add the arm back in. Do you know what I mean? So they didn't unmask the arm bit. But what you almost see here, if you look at the arm really carefully, is a faint line where the arm is supposed to be. So what that makes me think is they've edited the lighting a bit, the highlights, the shadows on them, and forgot to bring this highlight back down. Because you can kind of see it's just this really extreme, harsh white line that I feel they forgot to blend back down. So I don't, if you look really carefully, I don't think they've just like liquefied her arm really small, because that doesn't make sense. If they're making her body slimmer, they would have pulled it in, pulling that arm up. So they wouldn't have gone back in and liquefied it down to be really skinny. There's not much reason as to why it'll be super thin. I think it's an odd lighting trick, to be honest with you. A bit unsure, but it's very odd. Speaking of odd limbs, let's take a look at this picture of Khloe Kardashian. This is the glitchy thumb photo that it's all anyone could talk about for over like a day and a half on Twitter. So she posted this picture and immediately people were like, what's up with your thumb? What's going on with your thumb? Khloe actually replied to the comments after getting tons and tons of them and saying, babe, it's a glitch app. You can't control what it makes a glitch effect to. The fact that y'all think one would Photoshop thumbs concerns me a bit, but what the hell are you Photoshopping? I'm gonna dry my hair. I meant to be doing my hair and I've not even thought about it. Sometimes I will use a label MC salt spray if I want like a more casual look with a bit more kind of like rough texture. But I've really been liking this air dry foam from, I have no idea how to pronounce this brand. You're meant to leave it in wet hair and kind of let it air dry, but I find that this just gives me really nice texture when I blow dry it through and just use my hands to create texture. So I'm just going to apply two pumps of that. It's kind of like shimmy that through. And then we're going to blow dry. I do have this Dyson hair dryer. I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't get what all the fuss is about. I don't think it's like it makes that big a difference. I love going to like Sally's and getting the like salon hair dryers. I find there's more settings on them. They dry hair quicker than this, in my opinion. They're a lot more powerful. So I'm just gonna use my fingers to kind of like scrunch and pull back. My hair is very flat, so you're not gonna see a lot of texture, but it's more texture than I would have got if I just blow dried it normally. We'll be right back. Okay, there we go. You can see it's kind of created some kind of like volume, kind of. No, it has a lot of volume. Anyway, so she's used a glitch effect for sure. We can see it through her other fingernails. You can see a slight glitch effect and down her arm as well. If that was a motion blur, the sleeve around her would match up to that level of blur, if that makes sense. Of course, for motion blur, you have to be moving to get that blurred effect. So everything has to kind of be moving at the same time. You won't get different kinds of blurs. So yeah, it does look like a glitch effect, like on an app, whatever, a controlled glitch effect. Of course, we have the usual face app level editing. We all know she doesn't look like that. They have a reality series. We know what they look like. And it could be that the app used to filter her face has done something here too. But this can also happen for no known reason in apps that are loaded with filters and special effects. There's an app that I use called Snow because it has some amazing filters on it, just color filters, lighting filters, but they also have a ton of face altering effects. This picture here was taken on Snow whilst I was filming for another Instagram versus reality video. And whilst there's no effects on this picture, other than I think like a lighter filter, this is what the app did. It glitched my thumb. Like, why is there a line there? Like nothing's happened. So this can happen with apps that are loaded with special effects. I presume people are calling her out because they want to show that they know the pic's been edited, you know, once again by a Kardashian, but we don't need that glitchy thumb to know that. Do you know what I mean? Like, people are pointing out that thumb and be like, oh my God, this picture's been edited. I mean, look at the whole picture. Of course it's been edited. So yeah, I would just say that's a very odd kind of glitch effect on there. I don't think there's anything like facetious going on. Like, why would you Photoshop your thumb? I would think it's more that her thumb is so close to her face where she's applied effect that maybe it's glitched in that way, and then she's just used a general glitch app. But I think it's just the glitch effect doing weird stuff. One thing celebrities and influencers do is they blur the skin. We're talking facetune level blur. And then what they do is they add a noise back over the picture. Noise literally means speckled and that grainy kind of look. And this almost hides the fact that you completely blurred your skin by adding back in this kind of like fake texture. And whether or not that's Khloe's intention here, that's what's been done. But I don't think she was like editing her thumb and was like, oh, that's better. Now, this is what pisses me off. This is a picture of Kris Jenner. And I always say in these videos that I don't hate filters. Use them, enjoy them. Balance out what you're viewing online with like visual artwork and also some reality as well. Consume what makes you feel good, block what doesn't. What I hate is when brands, influencers, and celebrities use filters to sell product. Because it's a lie, it's all a lie. It's fake, it's stupid, and do you know what? They always do a bad job. They always do a bad job. They edit so poorly and they're like, oh, this looks good. Like, everyone's gonna think that's real. We're not stupid. I think that's what annoys me the most as well, is like celebrities think the public are stupid, that they're actually gonna believe that that's what they look like. So in June of 2017, Kris Jenner posted a picture of herself holding flat tummy tea. It was a disclosed paid promotion, meaning she was given money to promote this product and talk about its benefits. Flat tummy tea is essentially a weight loss tea that, in their own words, speeds up metabolism and reduces bloating. It also gives you the shits. I think that's how it works. It just gives you diarrhea. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that's all it does. I obviously have no problem with what people consume. If you think this aids you in a healthy lifestyle along with exercise and all that kind of stuff, knock yourself out. But I don't think they're good. But what you want to see with weight loss anything is a realistic before and after. Kris Jenner, who is already in very, very good shape, decided to fake the results of this tea by slimming herself down. We see all the usual signs, bendy wood in the background, warped background, and this weird uneven line in her arm where she's been using a liquify tool to reshape her arm, like probably like doing this, you know? And it's just made this weird, like, weird effect. This, in my opinion, should be illegal. Kris Jenner and Flat Tummy Tea should have been heavily fined if they weren't already. This is bad, especially when it comes to things like, someone, you know, I don't know, fakes mascara, whatever, for me is on a different level to promoting false effects of diet supplements. Faking results that are not result of a diet supplement can lead to, there's so many repercussions with this as far as people's mental health, eating disorders. I just don't know where to begin with this, and I do want to dedicate a whole like episode to diet supplements and the way they're promoted, because that I like sitting here now, I don't know where to begin. It's so dangerous. It's awful. It's awful. It's awful. It's awful. Let's talk about Kim's photoshopped kids. Right, I came across this video on TikTok. It's so odd. I'm just gonna play it for you. Whilst I style my hair with the Label M matte paste. This is just styling paste that has like a bit more texture in it. It's slightly drier, but really, really good hold as well. So let's watch this.
I would genuinely like to know why this family is so fucking weird. So earlier Kim posted this photo, and when I first looked at it, I instantly knew something was off. True just looks obviously photoshopped and like she's not really there, but I thought maybe I was crazy. But then this lovely Instagram page revealed that I am not crazy. True is photoshopped. Not only is she photoshopped, but she's photoshopped onto a photo of Stormy from October. And I was just so weirded out, because I'm like, maybe Kylie didn't want us to see Stormy, but Kim really wanted us to.
I can't do my hair in the monitor. Like, I look in the monitor here and it's like flipped. I don't know what I'm doing. Right, we're just going back with this. See what I mean? It's very pliable. It's easy to work around. Bear with me 1 second. I'm just going to look in a mirror.
See this photo of Chicago for some reason. So she photoshopped it. And I was really confused. But, you know, shortly thereafter, a couple hours later, Travis Scott makes his return to Instagram. And then it all sort of clicked, and I realized they're as calculated as ever, allegedly.
That will have to do. Looks so stupid on camera, okay. Digital manipulation has been used in publicity stunts and used to sway public opinion for decades. Decades. We talk here about how it's used in beauty, but it's how it's used in politics, which is a whole different and honestly more disturbing topic. As part of my dissertation, actually, when I was in university, my whole dissertation was about racism in the media and how people's skin tones are made lighter or darker to sway the public opinion about a particular celebrity, a person. I also focus on skin whitening and skin bleaching adverts. Two images I actually discuss is the magazine cover of OJ Simpson, Time magazine, where they purposely made his mugshot darker to give this more menacing appearance. And then the whitewashing of Beyonce and the L'Oreal Paris hair dye adverts. And I feel, again, this is something we can discuss in a completely separate video. Again, a big topic, which I want to sit down and do proper, you know, write a proper script for. So whilst this weird child photoshopping thing sounds kind of far-fetched, it's really not. It's something that's done all the time to make people feel a certain way about a particular celebrity. Kim's been known to photoshop her kids and slim them down, supposedly. This picture was actually posted to Kim's Instagram. She was blasted for photoshopping her child. Someone found the paparazzi picture that was posted and saw that her child's stomach had been slimmed down. I think her name's North. She'd been flattened. So people went crazy. She was accused of like photoshopping her kids, and everyone's like, typical to Kardashians. Again, you know, they'd already set the standard for her children of what's expected from a celebrity. However, Kim didn't actually do this. This picture was taken from a fan page, a Kim Kardashian fan page, and they had in fact slimmed down North's body. But people attacked Kim straight away because, let's be honest, this doesn't feel like something this family wouldn't do. I know that sounds awful, but they photoshopped their kids in the past, photoshopped their faces onto other kids, you know? This doesn't seem out of the ordinary for a Kardashian to do. It's sad. I always say in these videos that this is the standard expected from women, and it is. If you Photoshop or use too many filters, you are fake. But if you don't, the hate comments roll in. Always, always attacking the way a lady looks. And I was actually tagged in this video created by Lucy Mountain, who is a personal trainer, and I want you to listen to this.
Firstly, I am not a Kardashian fan, but I have to talk about these photos of Kourtney which are being shared right now. Photos of just a woman looking cute, just existing in her body. And these are the comments. This is why demanding raw and edited photos from your fave celebrities is not that simple. We are worryingly good at dehumanizing people online these days, but these are real people with real feelings. Just last week, Sydney Sweeney from Euphoria was trending on Twitter for being ugly, which is both deeply wild and also depressing. And so she went live in tears to show people exactly how this shit impacts people. We forget that this realness that we demand from public figures often comes at a cost. This isn't to excuse problematic behaviors like photoshopping. It is a problem, but in the fight against it, I think it's worth keeping some compassion. In a perfect world, everyone would feel comfortable showing up online exactly as they are. But in the meantime, I think it's worth understanding that not everyone is going to be a raw and edited body positive icon.
Yes, exactly what Lucy says. She said it perfectly. I've got nothing to add, really. I can guarantee you that the people who left Kourtney those disgusting hate comments, super unoriginal, super just awful people, they will be the first people in a comment section to call her out on overly editing her body. This is the reality that everyone wants, but you can't expect celebrities, influencers to take on the sheer amount of hate comments and judgment that they get and not feel like shit whenever they see an unedited picture of themselves or see themselves in the mirror. I personally do not think that banning filters is the way to go. I don't. I think educating people on how pictures are edited so that we can make an educated decision on what the picture is itself. We know what's real and what's not. I'm just gonna spray my hair with Tresemme hairspray, super hold, freeze hold. Been using it since I was like 14. It just keeps your hair in place, and when you have thick hair like mine, you don't want it to move. This family will never stop editing their pictures, ever. It's part of our generation. It's almost a fashion trend. We'll be reading about the trend of facetune and photoshopping, you know, in the future, laughing about it. And honestly, I think the only way we can show brands and influencers that we do not want filtered pictures in their paid promotion is not consume it, don't like it, don't support it. If you want reality, real bodies, real skin, whatever that means to you, whatever makes you comfortable, follow that, support that, promote it, share it. Get that seen more than what these brands and influencers and celebrities are doing. They all follow trends. They follow where the money is. So if the most popular thing, the most popular trend is unedited, raw photography, raw videos, and it's making money, that's where they're gonna go. That's when they're gonna follow. Last thing I do is run a brush through my beard. It's a beard brush because the bristles are a little bit thicker. Oh, there's some twirling there. A little bit thicker than what you get on like a normal brush, obviously. It needs a trim, really. But let me know what you think in the comments down below. You can watch the rest of the series here. Some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.